more capacity. We have to implement an all-of-the-above strategy. They talk about 3 or 4 or 5 years until some of the new capacity is online. Let me tell you, the demands are going to be a whole lot higher 3 and 4 and 5 years from now than they are now. If we don't get on with it, we're actually going backwards. And China and India and these other countries are growing. They're placing more demands on the world market. And with or without the finger pointing on oil and Bush, we have a problem that we as Americans have to go forward together to do together. And I close with this. They don't want to drill. They've opposed this all year, and I don't want to blame anybody, but the truth is, for months now, the Congress is waiting for votes on new capacity. They know the votes are there. This is a free country with elected leaders that have an obligation to bring up the votes so that we can move it forward, and we want that this week. The American people want that this week. I went through the magnetometer at the airport yesterday, and the lady said, drill now, pay less. We want it. I signed the petition. Get on with it. Didn't even have any idea I was coming down here. That's what the American people demand. We are responsible for the environment. We want to do it in a friendly way. We want green too, Jay, but we want green for U.S. jobs and exports and new technology, and do it with this robust free enterprise system we have, and not with a bunch of taxes and not with a bunch of regulations. And you can't limit your supply or you're going to pay more. That is a sharp contrast between the two parties. Let's go do it. Let's go do it now. Thank you all.
Well, thank you all. The audience has been great. I know that you all feel as passionately about this issue as the members of Congress do up here, and so I thank you for waiting right here until the bitter end to finally be able to express yourselves on both sides. And thank you, Tulane.